Maximum firepower.
This is my latest LEGO creation, a fully motorized, remote-controlled Star Wars Imperial Walker. It can walk, turn, move its head, and shoot rubber bands. It's the coolest thing I've built out of LEGO so far. I learned mechanical engineering and robotics as I designed and built this model. Here's how I did it. I've actually built and rebuilt this robot multiple times, making it a little bit better each time. I think it's pretty much as good as it's going to get right now. I started from one of LEGO's own designs, this AT-AT from the Dark Side Developer Kit. I never actually owned this LEGO set, but when I found the instructions online, I just had to build it. However, the design itself was somewhat unsatisfactory. Its single motor could only move the robot forwards and backwards in a preset pattern. I wanted it to be able to walk and shoot, but I only had one motor and it could only power one thing at a time. What to do? Turns out there's a simple solution called a ratchet. A ratchet will change its position depending upon which way the gears are spinning. So in this case, when the motor was spinning clockwise, the ratchet would send power to the legs, and when the motor was spinning counterclockwise, the ratchet would send power to the gun. Mechanical power like this is transmitted through a gear train, which is pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It's a series of gears with the teeth linked together. Now, I used to build gear trains that looked like this one. This turned out to be a terrible idea. It's actually best to use as few gears as possible. This minimizes both friction and backlash, which is what happens when the tiny spaces in between gear teeth add up over the length of a gear train. Too much backlash is a bad thing. Anyway, with all the gears in place, my robot was successfully able to walk forward and shoot intermittently. However, the gun I had built was weak and impossible to aim. I wanted something more powerful. That's when I picked up this book. The authors call it Forbidden LEGO because the LEGO group would never publish instructions this dangerous. I actually did almost shoot my eye out with this powerful and fully automatic LEGO gun. My version of the gun was somewhat smaller and didn't require that I physically cut any of the gears to make it work. I wanted to mount the gun onto my walker, but this gun requires a lot of force to shoot and my one and only motor was simply not powerful enough. Now usually when a motor's not powerful enough to do something, you can just gear it down. I'm sure you're already familiar with the idea of gearing up and down if you've driven a car or a bicycle. These two vehicles are exactly the same except for the gearing on the side. The vehicle that's geared up is a lot faster, and the vehicle that's geared down has a lot more torque. To fire my awesome gun, I had to gear down so much that the gun was just way too slow. I wanted a gun that could fire rapidly, so clearly I needed a better design. With a bit of Googling, I found a design for a simple rubber band gun that looked like this one, which perfectly suited my needs. This gun doesn't need a lot of power, it can hold a lot of ammo, fire rapidly, and it has decent accuracy. My version of this gun needed to have a worm gear. Worm gears impart a lot of torque, and they also cannot be moved by the gear they are meshed with. Without a worm gear, the rubber bands would fire themselves as soon as the motor stopped running. This new gun worked really well, and I was satisfied with my model, which could now walk forwards and shoot rubber bands intermittently using only one motor. Then one day I found this set on Craigslist at half price and I couldn't pass it up. I hadn't bought any new LEGO since I was a kid, so I figured, why not? As far as I'm concerned, this is one of the greatest Technic sets ever produced. The model is brilliantly designed, and it's got four motors with everything you need to remote control them, along with treads, linear actuators, and lots of other useful parts. Once I'd had my fun with the excavator, I disassembled it and used its parts to completely rebuild my Imperial Walker. At this point, the only thing remaining from LEGO's original instructions was the design of the legs. Long robot legs are really hard to design, so I left them alone. Now that I had four motors to work with, I could get rid of the ratchet. Now my motors could have dedicated functions, one for walking, one for shooting, and a third motor I wanted to use for steering. Of course, steering a vehicle with wheels is much easier than steering a vehicle with legs. I had no idea of how to do it, so I watched Star Wars again just to see how those robots moved around. It turns out these are not robots. They were animated with stop motion. Here's one of the animators talking about how they did it.
At one time, there was like no decisions how to do any of this stuff, and all there were these wonderful color artworks that Ralph had done of the big walking machines. So we had to figure out how we're going to do this, and one of the thoughts was to make a robot. But my background is, before Star Wars, was really in stop motion animation. And so I pushed to do it in stop motion because they're machines anyway, and if they move sort of like a little staccato-like, it would just make them look more like machines. So we did it in stop motion, and we did it with models that were as big as a person can animate, which is about the size that a person can get their hands in to move it frame at a time.
So anyway, the movie didn't have anything useful to show me about how to make my robot turn. Then I remembered a type of steering I had read about in a book called articulated steering. With articulated steering, the entire vehicle is split in half and it rotates around that point. This allows for wheels to remain fixed onto the chassis, which is important for certain kinds of vehicles. But would it work with legs instead of wheels? I had to build it to find out. As it would happen, yes it does. I used a turntable to split my robot in half. Unfortunately, this would also split the main drive shaft in half. The drive shaft has to extend across the entire robot, because, in this case, all four legs have to be perfectly synchronized in order for the robot to walk properly. The solution was a carefully placed universal joint, which allows for power to be transferred at any angle. I used another worm gear for the articulated steering. Again, because a worm gear cannot be forced to move, the robot remains rigid and only moves when I want it to. This steering system works really well. The legs do slip a little bit while the robot is turning, but it's not a big deal as long as it stays on a solid, flat surface. This thing was not built for rugged terrain.
Oh boy. Oh no!
He's stuck on the tape.
So now my robot had walking, steering, and shooting. That's three different functions using three motors, but I had four motors available, so what else could I add? A friend suggested that the robot's head should be able to pivot up and down. I realized that this would greatly improve the accuracy of the rubber band gun. Perfect. I used a linear actuator to make it work. The basic idea here is that you've got two worm gears meshed together. Because the pieces can move freely past each other, rotational motion is converted into linear motion. This model illustrates the same concept, using a rack gear instead. And with that, my robot was finally complete. That's the whole thing. If you'd like to build or take a closer look at this robot, you can download the LEGO Digital Designer file, which I've linked to below. You don't have to be an engineer to make something like this. I just took a lot of ideas from a lot of different sources and put them together. When I started building with Technic, I didn't know anything useful about mechanical engineering. I learned everything I know by messing around with LEGO, reading books, Googling things, and watching YouTube videos. And if you've been paying attention to my YouTube video, you've now learned a little bit about ratchets, gear trains, backlash, torque, worm gears, articulated steering, universal joints, and linear actuators. All of these concepts are much bigger than LEGO. We're surrounded by mechanical things all the time. It's undoubtedly useful to know even a little bit about the functionality of your bicycle or car or whatever you happen to drive. A lot of concepts are easier to grasp when you're able to play with them. And LEGO is a great way to learn about this stuff because if you can get your hands around it, you can get your mind around it.
If you're interested in learning more about engineering with LEGO, I highly recommend this book, which I've linked to below. Or any book, really. Go to the library. I hope you enjoyed this premiere episode of Self-Taught. There are plenty more videos in the works, so if you'd like to see more, hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and stay curious.